In a metaphor, really, music engages, like an orchestra, many parts of the brain that have to interact and communicate with each other. With the advance of technology such as brain imaging, magnetic resonance imaging, functional MRI, and also electrophysiology, EEG, we are able to see activity of the brain while we listen to music. And as a result of that, we've been able to see that not only changes in the auditory cortices and auditory regions of the brain are observed as a result of music training, there's also engagement of other parts of the brain. These include the motor system, the cerebellum that keeps track of the beat and the rhythm, the reward system of the brain, the affective system that processes emotion and affect, memory engagement, and also executive network. We have been studying how engagement with music, so not only passively listening to music, but actually learning how to play a musical instrument, changes child's neurodevelopment. And by that, I mean how it changes their brain, their cognitive abilities, but also their social emotional learning capacities. We have observed advantages of music training, not only in terms of better speech and language and auditory perception, but we also observe changes in the systems of the brain that are responsible for planning and executive functioning, for impulse control and inhibition, and also the connectivity between the left and the right side of the brain, so more integration and communication between brain regions. We also have really interesting results in terms of their social emotional well-being, how these children who have been part of the music and orchestra are less hyperactive and less aggressive as reported by their parents and their family members. We have recently finished a study looking at what listening to nostalgic music, so music that is meaningful to you personally, music that brings back memories and emotions for you, can provide access to some of the memories that in the case of dementia and Alzheimer's disease may not be accessible. Now, music is not the cure for Alzheimer's, it's not going to stop Alzheimer's, but what we think is that it provides a tool in the toolbox to enhance quality of life. The conference is sponsored by the Center for Music, Brain and Society at USC to see how we can collaborate better, how we can put all efforts together in a way to push this field forward so it can not only provide scientific result and research, but it can make a change in terms of both education and health policy and also clinical practices for patients.